Welcome back, everyone, to our open mic by the Youth of City Center SDHH. We're continuing with our conversation on unequal yoking. Yeah, very popular subject. People, SDA people love this. I don't know why. You know, lady, I turned. You guys like talking about unequal yoking. Yeah, mind you, some of us, we like being unequally yoked. So, yeah. Anyway, we'll continue our conversation. Moses actually had a line of thought that he had before we went on our break. So yeah, we're still talking about financials.
Oh, yeah, I think I was saying it's more of a concluding statement to say, in order to be equally yoked with someone financially, on a financial level,
yeah,
it's not an issue of the amount of wealth they have or the difference in wealth. Mm-hmm. But the issue is, you yourself, are you able to function without
that person? Yes.
Can you be? Can we say you're a normal individual, an average citizen, without their world contributing to your own life?
All right.
I think it also removes certain. It helps you in terms of vulnerability. It doesn't make you that vulnerable to someone. They can be abusive and controlling. If you know that you can't live without them, you would die.
Yeah. They control you.
They can do anything and get away with it in the relationship. And some of these things can end up being toxic and abusive.
And you won't be able and to just, it ends in tears.
Yeah, and you know, your self esteem will drop because you're thinking, and I'm married.
Yeah. What would I do without him?
That's interesting. In fact, that statement that you just said, I've heard many widows. Okay,
That's not funny.
Yeah. Okay, I know. In fact, let me not even finish what I was saying.
No, just
now let us move on. Let us move on to another form of unequal yoking, which is spiritual. Yeah, people love talking about this one.
I think right now in the comment sections, the SDAs are going like,
This is our zone. Yeah. So there's apparently there's spiritual unequal yoking.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that there's actually like a yardstick to measure spiritual levels of a person. But I'm sure Ukona, like it can happen that you as a person, your spiritual levels, your connection with Jesus and God and the church and so on, may be different from.
From the next person
that you just happen to be attracted to,
you
know. If that's the case, I think Mike, the question that I would pose to you and also the viewers is it worth dating a person like that, that where your levels of spirituality are obviously different.
Obviously different in terms of what, like. I think they
read their Bible and pray every day and you don't.
Yeah. Okay, yeah,
I want to start a day of sharing it does. Then you go out to church, but there, man, it's like your phone. It's always clean.
So in a way, we are talking about spiritual yoking whilst in the church, not necessarily someone... who is of a different church?
We're just talking spiritual yoking in a general sense. I think limiting it to a division might be tricky. And not only that, but I believe there are people within the church that also don't want people in the church, and we need to, we're young people and we're dealing with the facts in the ground. We can't lie to one another that, in the church will around you, will find you one. The only truth is some of us don't, ones are not in the church.
We are not
there. We don't want, even if we see them in the church, we
don't want them.
We don't want them. We want the ones that are outside.
We want the ones outside. So one of my feelings dying.
So I think we need to be realistic on that perspective. And also, I think we need to be taking cognizant of the fact that some people, equal yoking might be getting someone outside.
Okay.
I think...
That's... Yeah. Yeah. Even spiritually.
Yeah. I was talking to one of my... I have many friends that I talk to. Don't you?
Yeah, okay. Please.
And he goes like, I'm a freaky person.
Yeah, freaky.
Yeah, like, go to the same church, but he goes like, me, I'm a freaky person, Moses. You don't understand that. So...
For the benefit of viewers at home, please...
I love
it. It's not great when the term freaky person. What do you mean?
they have no rules or limitations when it comes to sexual intimacy.
They are sexual deviants.
Yeah, they really don't. They don't kiss. They don't do this whole "what a church." I don't kiss you. What a church couple. I don't kiss you.
Anytime, anytime,
anytime, please.
You know.
And they were saying that I don't think I can fit in a relationship, even no matter how good the girl is, if she doesn't have that freaky side, that freaky element. If
okay.
she
doesn't satisfy that.
If she doesn't satisfy his freaky part.
All right, yes.
And at the same time, he's saying, I also want someone who's freaky. I can't be the one with engineering ideas. I'm just there, you know what? Okay. What different?
All right.
So I think we have to be realistic with this.
This is on spiritual?
Yeah, what? Spiritual.
Okay. I feel like we went back to
sexual, but yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
That, the reason I'm saying is that I think sexual and spiritual are kind of related to some extent.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So we need to be aware that some people, yes, they go to church, they love Jesus, but they're
freaky.
Yeah, they're freaky. Day, yes.
They're freaky. We can't force them.
Yeah. Where they, okay, all right. So, are we saying that being freaky is not spiritual? Like a spiritual person can also be freaky at the same time. It's like water and oil, doesn't it? All right. No, it's fine.
Oh, how do we then draw the line between what's freaky enough but still spiritual? But you get it?
Hey! What's freaky enough but still spiritual?
I know.
This one I don't know. As an unmarried person, therefore a virgin, I don't know what exactly people are talking about now. But I think on spiritual, my conclusions, I like to pick.
Please.
Put them at the beginning. My conclusion is that, again, deity type yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If you're one of those people that values more than anything, and I think most Christians should be like this anyway, if you value your Christian walk
mm-hmm.
with Jesus, and you feel like no matter how attracted you are to a certain girl or a certain guy, it impedes on that. I feel like it would be unequal yoking for you to still go through with it and say, no, let me, because that person can actually drag you back.
Mm-hmm.
So for the sake of your own spiritual, well-being, for you to progress and not regress, channel her.
Mm-hmm.
Even if she's beautiful, even if he's got mine, you might as well just leave it alone. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I want to agree with you on that one. In that, if someone is at a different level, it means you're going to spend most of your time trying to make them like you.
Mm.
And
yeah.
sometimes you might not even realize it, that's what you're doing.
Mm.
But your energy is concentrated on, I want them to not do this, I want them to not do this.
Yeah.
But we all have choices.
Yeah.
So in a way, you'll be manipulating someone.
Yeah.
And you're trying to shape them into someone
whom
they are not.
Yeah.
So it won't change who that person really is. Yes, they may try to keep up and all, but eventually they'll be who they are.
Yeah.
So just be with someone who moves at the same pace as you so that you won't have trouble trying to put a lot of work on someone. Because it's both of you, you're working. He's trying to be what you want him to be. I'm trying to make him what I want to be. So we are all putting so much energy on things we can avoid by being with someone you can walk.
In fact, the conclusion to my conclusion is going to be an example.
Yeah.
If I'm not saying this is you, but for example, let's say if you're one of those people, you know those women that come to divine service late, like at 11 o'clock, really, after singing song and they leave just after church,
mm-hmm.
right? That's, I think it sort of reflects your own spiritual level.
Yeah.
I hardly think that you would get along well on a spiritual level, or like on spiritual levels, the person on Gena HH
or
8 Asuki after Vespers.
You spend
minutes at church and you spend hours at church.
I
think those two behaviors are reflective of your two different characters as far as spirituality is concerned.
And
your
pride,
exactly. So I my conclusion young girls are pretty good.
So wait, but I think as we conclude, the viewers can share what they think.
Mm-hmm.
And this is probably the last thing that I'll say.
Yeah.
What happens if the person ticks all the boxes, but then end up being too spiritual? Or
the other way
around. They still tick all the boxes, but hey,
Yeah, okay. That now depends on you and what you value the most.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It depends on you and what you value the most. If you value spirituality, if you value money, if you value, what's the other one that we talked about?
Social.
Yeah, exactly.
Social influence.
Exactly. Yeah. It depends on which of those three you value and prioritize the most. That will ultimately influence whether you are going to take that person or
not. And it also depends on what you as an individual can live with.
Exactly.
If you can live with a person who doesn't like church, let's just say
doesn't like church, yeah.
If it's okay with you, and if it doesn't, you know, sugar your spirit too much, like, then I think...
Go ahead.
And it's wrong for us to start to impose and say, if that person doesn't like God or think that have to do with church, then, but ticks all the other boxes, no, that person is out of the question. But what sits well with you? With you as a person, with your spirit, is what goes in the end.
I think the general conclusion is then we need a lot of self-awareness before we can go in a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You need to know where you're yoked with this whole financial, all those things. You need to know where you stand before you can ask someone else to stand on your side. Stand by me. As I sounded, don't you?
In your head.
It's just like, wow.
Yeah. But I think from this whole talk, that's what I get.
All right.
Self-awareness is key
mm-hmm.
before you can ask someone to come in and join you in your walk.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
With Christ.
All right.
said walk. I just finished the
talk. Yeah, we've come to the end of our open mic for today. Yeah, thank you for tuning in thus far. If you have been listening to us for this long, it says a lot about your own personal spiritual level. Yeah, so as I was saying, don't date anyone below those spiritual levels. Thank you so much for tuning in. Jesus is very happy about that.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'll just...
for listening to us.
Exactly. Let's just run through the panel once again.
Should I start again?
Again.
Okay. Once again, my name is Amiela Spanda.
And you are not married?
I'm single.
Yeah, but willing to date bisexual people.
My name is Moses Kororo. Guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I feel like a YouTuber.
Yeah, and comment.
Definitely comment. Yeah. Like, maybe topics.
Even if you disagree with what I'm saying, that's not the other part. It's okay.
And I'm Nyasha Zifungo. Yeah, the surname will change eventually.
Yes.
But for now, I'm Nyasha Zifungo.
And my name is Bui.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.